Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We're now going to look at conformations of propane through Newman projections. So I have just simply taken my, in the previous video we did ethane, and I've simply taken that exact same screen and just crossed out ethane and written propane and made a couple other small changes. So what were those small changes? Well, first we're looking at propane. So here is ethane. Toward the bottom left. And when we did ethane, we did a Newman projection. We looked down the carbon-carbon bond. And so here's a sawhorse diagram of ethane. And now here's propane. Almost the exact same picture, except we have a methyl group written off of the carbon. So all of our Newman projections reflect that. We now have a methyl group sticking up at this position instead of a hydrogen. And that slightly changes our picture. So in our first picture, we have an eclipsed conformation, eclipsed Newman projection. And I'm going to flag this methyl group and this particular hydrogen and use those as points of reference and say here is our dihedral angle of 0 degrees. Now, what is the energy of this structure? Well, we know that these hydrogen-hydrogen eclipsing interactions cost us 1.0 kcals per mole. And so there's another one over here, 1.0. And this is going to be something higher. So this is torsional strain, we said before. These sigma bonding electrons repel each other. Well, we're going to get the same kind of repulsion in the case of this methyl and this hydrogen, except it's going to be a little bit more. It's actually about 1.3 kcals per mole. Some people say it's 1.4, but it's in that neighborhood. So the total energy of this eclipse conformation, for which we have a dihedral angle of 0, looking now at our energy diagram, this is going to be at 3.3 kcals per mole. As we open up our angle to a dihedral of 60, we get to a staggered conformation, Newman projection. And now we have alleviated all that torsional strain. All these eclipsing interactions are gone. All these sigma bonds are nicely separated. So we actually go down to a relative energy of 0. Now let's rotate another 60 degrees. I'll flag the methyl and I'll flag this hydrogen on the back carbon. And now we've opened up to a dihedral of 120. And this again is an eclipsed conformation. And we go back up to the same 3.3 values. We have a hydrogen-hydrogen eclipse interaction, that's 1. Hydrogen-hydrogen, that's 1. And then this is again 1.3. So we go back up to 3.3, and then if we continue opening this up to 180, we go back to a staggered conformation, and that is 0. And so we get this kind of energy curve. Looks very much very much like what we saw with ethane. So we can take these same ideas. What we've added is a new energy. We've added this 1.3 kcals per mole. Pen is not catching. 1.3 kcals per mole for a hydrogen methyl eclipsing interaction. But it's the exact same ideas that we saw with ethane in the previous video.